A great big hello to you, my Minecraft friend. I'm the Radio Man 03, and as always, it is awesome to have you along. Hope you're doing well. Hope you enjoyed your weekend. Another Monday through Friday, a Life in the Woods Renaissance, right here, right now. Why am I in the graveyard when I said we're going to be done with the graveyard? Well, if you remember last episode, I talked about the fact that we were going to be... Wrong one. We were going to be doing... Let's do some overtime work in the graveyard. I did a little extra work out here. Not much. I got this labeled. There we go. March 20th, 2016, Spider Push Radio into a ravine. And then late Friday night, as I was working on the path up to the graveyard, I died April 30th, 2016. It was the wee hours of the morning. Fell into a ravine twice, in capital letters, twice. The same ravine. I was really tired, was not paying attention, jumped over a hill, and nowhere really unusual either. It's where we've been before, just over in the little wooded area next to us. So I was just kind of scouting around looking for stuff, you know? And I jumped over the edge, and I wound up going right into a ravine. And then I ran back out there again to get our stuff, of course, and I wound up jumping into the ravine again. I thought I was going to ride some vines down to the bottom, missed the vines, and just died. But anyways, we've got two more deaths, both in the same ravine. I did recover all of our things. They're fine. Of course, we have the headstones down there. But this is how we're looking up here right now. So we've got our post to tie off the horses when we come up here. And Rascal has to sit out here as well, because you know what the dogs do. They'll walk right into those death blooms and stuff. So now we have a path. We've got some lighting on the way up as well. I'll come back down to the bottom here so you guys can kind of look back up the trail. But there we go. There's our little dirt path going up the hill towards the cemetery, huh? Not too shabby, with slabs and stairs and stuff. I put stairs here and there in the road itself to give it kind of some little potholes here and there. Then we come back through here. And I didn't do anything out here for the sole fact that we are out in the wild now. So I wanted to kind of leave this as wild as possible. So I didn't do any decor work or add flowers or anything. All I did was add the light posts in here with the dead wood. That's all I did out here. But yeah, we've got plenty of animals roaming around. You can see the sheep and stuff. And this just this nice little pathway leads all the way back. And it actually goes in between all of our really nice trees here. And this is how we get back and forth to the barn with the horses. And then, of course, we can just bring them right back in like so. Yeah, just like that. Perfect, huh? Just perfect. So yeah, we've got ourselves a little bit of path now all the way out to the graveyard, which is one of the things we wanted to get done. I wanted to bring it all the way out to the village, but that gives us something to come back to here later on down the road and to work on as well sometime in the future. Hope everybody had a great weekend. I did. Bridie and I, we had some fun Saturday, and then Sunday we just sat around and watched movies literally all day long and just enjoyed movies. It was really nice. Look at this here. The hay piles. The hay is coming in. I've been harvesting the hay and filling up the barn up top here. Let me show you over on this side here so you guys can see. But yeah, it's just jam-packed. We're going to fill this all up with hay up here before we head out to the new location to trade with the horse trader out there. Yeah. So we've got the hay going real nice. Bred the pigs a couple more times so we have more pork. This tree, for some reason, keeps growing over in the area where we tested out, the Ukali tree. And it just keeps coming back out there. So I've chopped it down numerous times. What else did I do over the weekend that you guys may not be aware of? I took down the fir tree, the little miniature fir tree that we had right here. I took that out because it was just too much right there. And I moved it over to... Let's go over to the bridge here real fast so you guys can see it. We've got a little adventuring to do today. A little different adventuring, but nevertheless, it is adventuring. Here it is, right there. I put that little fir tree in the pot right out here by the water. I thought that looked pretty good. We're going to get another one. We've got the Nusus one right here, which is nice. I can never remember the name of that tree because we've got so many now. I've got to look at them all the time. Eventually, I'll get them down. And then over on this side of the bridge, I took down the dead tree that was right here at the end of it. And I kind of opened this up a little bit. Not too much. I didn't want to, you know, change it too much and alter it. Just a little bit. How's the traps doing? Oh, baby. Look at that. Look at that. So much food in there. Yes. Lots of meat. Oh, boy, I've got stuff in our inventory for us to get to work on right away today. We got lots of great stuff in the traps. Awesome. I only put 16 foods in there, 16 baits. So, yeah, it's not a whole lot of stuff, but it's more than we had just a little bit ago. Yeah, I'm trying to get the food stocked up so when we move, we could take seeds from everything and have a good supply of food here. If we ever have an emergency, we could just come back here and pick it up. Something else I noticed over the weekend, we had a second mahogany tree grow all on its own. planted itself and grew right up next to the other one, if you can notice that right here. I didn't even see it happen, but it did. But there you go. We got a mahogany tree here, and now we've got one back there too. So our little forested pond area here is actually looking really good. I like the way the pond looks. It's got a lot of great color in it with the berries and stuff growing around it, the different height cattails and everything, the magic tree. It all adds quite a bit to our little pond. Okay, and I believe it was Mord Sith who said I should build some sort of a crane holding a... Are you doing anything here? There's a peppercorn. I've been watching the peppercorn pretty regularly. There we go. No. Just the one, huh? Okay, just one peppercorn. That's okay. But maybe a crane holding a boat would be good out here by the fishing hut. So I tried to put a boat on the chain, but that doesn't work. So I put another crane out here. But I took those metal blocks that we got off that building, and I put those down here. And then we have our scaffolding blocks right here. Did I hear a mob? Thought I heard a growl. And then we've got the iron, the wrought iron work going on here. Nice, huh? With a little chain and then a crate being held up right there. So yeah, I put a little crane out here by the fishing hut. Thought that was kind of cool. And I think that's about it. We still need to do some landscape work around here. We need to add a little something right here. A lot of this bamboo is going to come down, but we do need to do a little bit of landscape work right here along the water's edge. And we'll take care of that. We'll do that together. But I think those are the things I accomplished late Friday night. And then, I died twice. I went back into that forest right back in there and wound up dying twice in a ravine. So what are you going to do? Yeah, that's what lesson learned. Don't play at night when you're tired and it's late. Variety said 3, she's home today. She suggested we have carrot cake for our food today. So we are going to have carrot cake. We're going to dine on some sweets. So there's the recipe for that if you guys didn't see it. It's dough balls, the carrots, and sugar in the baking pan. We're going to throw that peppercorn in right there. Actually, you know what? We're not going to throw that right in there. We're going to go ahead and take care of it right now while we've got it, while we're thinking about it. Boom, boom, pepper. Beautiful. I've been stocking up on the pepper. Every time I see those guys out there, I stock it up. So we're up to 5. Ooh, so many. Okay, and we made that. So we made the food. We have food. While we're thinking about it, let's just do this right here. Shift, click, boom. Diamond armor on, baby. Diamond armor. We are going into the danger zone today. We're going to go back into the Nether. We found an atlas on one of our recent explorations, a brand new atlas. I want to take that atlas into the Nether and get that atlas opened up, and that's going to be our Nether atlas, so we always have a map for there. But right now, we're going to make some fire resistance potions because our armor does not have fire resistance on it. And if you remember, when we go into this portal, there are a lot of those fire blocks. And ooh, that's something else I want to make sure I do is we take our silk touch shovel so we can see if we can grab some of those fire blocks. Oh, delicious. I made some fresh coffee before I sat down. Wonderful. Wunderbar. Let's get this guy up here first. This is going to extend our potions nicely. We could throw those in there. I brought one of these just in case, just for the heck of it. And then I've got a few things else I've got to put away. Fire resistance. Oh, very nice, very nice. These are going to be very handy. Look at the carrot cake. That looks pretty darn good, doesn't it? We just had carrot cake, and Friday's like, well, what kind of cakes can you make, or pies? And I said, well, I can make carrot cake. And she's like, carrot cake it is. Make it. So that's what we got, carrot cake. We're going to put the potions right down here. And you know what? I'm going to gather up a few more things. We're taking our gray backpack with us. We've never used this one. This was one of the green backpacks that we changed the color of, and then we could open it, which is really nice. So I want to get a couple stacks of cobblestone. There's a couple of things in the Nether I want to do. Number one, I want to get this atlas set up to be our Nether atlas. We have our scythe with us. There's a tree in the Nether called the Hellbark tree, and I would love to get a sapling of the Hellbark tree. I understand it's a very beautiful tree, and we need one. So let me get a few more things put together here, and then we will set off into the Nether, and that's only part of our adventuring episode today, so do stick around. I shall be right back. Well, unfortunately, I cannot find our silk touch shovel. I do not know what I did with it. I have no idea. I played late Friday night. I got on Saturday for about an hour, and I dug this out right here. And part of what we have to deal with today is this little situation down here. There's something underneath here. But this is going to be the brew room, and we're going to put this together this week as well. This is kind of the last big project I can think of down here. And I did run into some of the raw marble, which was pretty cool. Almost 2 stacks of raw marble, so we have some of that. But this is going to be our little brewing room down here. We'll have our chests and our brew stands and stuff like this down here. Stairs, 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 stair, coming back up here like so. So yeah, piece of cake, right? Piece of cake. All right, I think I've got everything we need. Let's get a little bit of food. I grabbed quick food items just so we could be in and out when we go to eat. We could eat really fast and get our health to start regenerating quickly. Okay, here we are back in the Nether again. First thing we want to do, though, is get our book and activate this guy so we can see just exactly what's going on. Right-click on it, and boom, open it up. There we go. Oh, wow, that's cool. Look at this. This is quite descriptive. This is... Okay, there's Nether Fortress there, but it says there's Nether Fortress behind us and to our right. Is that right? No, right over here. Okay. Really? Nether Fortress over that way, huh? That's good to know. You know what? I've got our fortune pick with us. We really didn't need to bring the fortune pick. Let's put the fortune pick up here, and we're going to move everything down a little bit, and that's going to make it better. Then we can keep food on our bar like so. Backpack. Oh, come here. There we go. I have no idea where that ghast is. It looks a little brighter in here this time around, doesn't it? It's not quite as dark. That's kind of nice. Let's go ahead and drink a fire resistance potion just to be on the safe side. There we go. And that's going to last us for 8 minutes. All right, let's go see if we can't... Oh, they must have done something to fix this and make it look a little bit better because, yeah, it is not nearly as dark in here as it was the first time we were in here. I mean, we can see where we're walking. I can see where I'm walking much better. There are trees right over here, and I'm hoping it doesn't say oak, and I'm hoping it says hellbark tree. I'm really, really hoping it does say something like that. Hellbark leaves. We actually... Jeez, I tell you, those ghast are just absolutely insane with their scream. It's just unbelievably nuts. All right, let's... Okay, that should have gotten us one, right? That should have gotten us a sapling, right? Hellbark saplings. Okay, beautiful. That is one thing we wanted while we're in here. And since that went so fast, let's see if there's anything else we can find. We don't have our silk touch shovel, like I said. I'm really disappointed by that because I wanted to get some of these blocks that are on fire here. Where were they? I don't even know. These flowers, I think, are growing actually on those blocks. Tons of soul sand in here. And we do still have armor. No, that's not it. That's not what I was looking for. Where are those blocks with the fire in them? I thought they were all over the place in here last time we came in here. They seem like they were everywhere. Oh, there's hellbark stuff over there too. So yeah, we've got 3 hellbark saplings. That's nice. And it looks like the persimmon grows on those as well. There's some flesh blocks, but what happened to those fire ones? That's weird. We had like a bunch of those here. Well, there's the ghast. There he is. That's what I thought, ghast. Take a back seat, baby. Take a back seat. I did want to grab as well... I know, I get all quiet as soon as the ghast starts shooting, huh? They're scary. I wanted to take this with me as well. I want to put that up in the graveyard just to have... wow, is this different than it was last time? Let's take a look at our atlas real quick. Oh my gosh, yeah, we've got fortress over here and fortress over there, right behind us. There is a fortress over here somewhere. Very cool. Well, we might as well do a little exploring, right? We're here. Oh, look at the gravestones down in here. Oh, what's this here? Eye bulb? Oh, Oh my gosh, eye bulb. That's weird. I wonder what you do with eye bulb. Let's see. Eye bulb. Biomes of plenty. Nothing. It doesn't look like you do much of anything with it. It's just eye bulb. We didn't really explore in here last time. It got to be such a crazy mess. Oh, wow. Look at the mushrooms in here and stuff, too. Oh, I didn't know that. I didn't know it was going to have mushrooms in it. That's very cool. Maybe we will try to get a couple more of these hellbark saplings. No? Just the eyeball things. Oh, wow. That's a sizable fortress over there, too, huh? Where is that? It's just right over there. It's right over there on that ledge. Or is it up on top here, maybe? Pretty cool. Let me get the torch back on for us so we can see. Lots of persimmons, huh? Don't need persimmons. I want the hellbark saplings. Oh, we got some right away. We've got two, so I guess two's enough, huh? Two's enough. Yeah, two is enough. How did we get in here? Bunch of flesh. Right through here, I believe. Yeah, right through here. Cool. This is pretty neat, too. I've never seen that before. Can we get through over here, or is this kind of a dead end right here? I think if we use our fortune pick, we should be able to get more quartz, right? There's some quartz right here. Yeah, let's grab a little bit of quartz. In the GEI, when we get building on that, I want to get more into the automation. Some of the automation stuff that's available for this. We're going to have, you know, sticky piston doors that open and close behind us. And, you know, it's going to have a much different look to it than the farm does. And I'm looking forward to that. Getting into some of the redstone. I know we've got that redstone paste. I would love to experiment with that a little bit and see what it does, because that looks really cool as well. So yeah, there's going to be more redstone. Well, there's going to be redstone. More redstone. I think the only thing we have redstone right now is the portal itself that we just came through, because we could turn it on and off. But that's about all there is redstone inside our entire world right now. But I would like to, do more of that, for sure. Because that is fun to have things automated a little bit. But I think we need to be careful on how much automation we do. For the sole fact that you don't want to cause a bunch of lag. There we go. A little bit of that there. We're going to take this back down. I think we're going to get ourselves turned around if we're not careful in here. And then, well, we've got our atlas, don't we? What's this here? Okay, we've been through here. All right, so were we down below? We were down below here, huh? Yeah, down below here. The Nether, very easy to get yourself turned around in here, but fortunately we have the Atlas now, so that's pretty nice. I should mark on the map where the portal is, huh? I didn't think about that. I just assumed that it would be there and show itself to us, but that is not the case. We need to go back and mark that. Yes, indeed. Oh, nice. Get some quartz, huh? This stuff is going to be coming in real handy for us. Let's see. Let me try to get some light on for you guys. I really need to try to remember to do that for you guys, because it is difficult to see in here. Although, I have to say it's a little bit better in here than it was last time. A little bit brighter in here, which is nice. But yeah, if we can grab a little bit of quartz, that'd be awesome. Maybe enough XP so we can do the name tags for the animals, too. We have four name tags for our four horses. I should say three horses and a donkey. Oh, God. Oh, lava. Fire resistance. Thank goodness I got fire resistance on, or I would be in some serious trouble right now. Whew. Big trouble. We do need to eat some food. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why you have fire resistance potions. That is why you do fire resistance potions, because that would have killed us if I had not had those potions. That would have been awful. But fortunately, we do, so we don't have to worry about it at all. We swim right through it. Did my heart drop when that happened just now? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. It sank big time. but we're okay. All right, let's see. What do we got going on here? Wow, that fortress is like right here. I sure wish I could see it. Let's try to get over here a little bit. This is just part of our adventure today. We want to go up here a little bit and see. See what that fortress is. Oh, what do we have here? Glow shroom. Oh, that's cool looking. Oh, there's all kinds of plant life in here I didn't know we could pick up. That's really awesome. Oh, there it is. There's the fortress, right? Is that what I'm looking at? It says we're... Oh, it's right here. We're on it. It's right there. Oh, man, and we traveled such a great distance to get to the other part of the fortress. This one looks like it stretches all the way over here, over to there as well. It's much, much, much larger, for sure. And it's definitely embedded in lava down below. A lot of nastiness down there. Okay, so that's cool. We've got another fortress here. And I would imagine that we'll find another fortress when we exit over where the GEI is going to be built, huh? Yeah, that should be pretty cool. Did I get another one? Nope, still two. Just two saplings. Just the two saplings so far. But that's okay, we've got some. So that's the main goal. Oh man, I wish they would... wish they'd share a little bit more, but they don't seem to be. It's really, really difficult to get those hellbark saplings. There's another one. There's another one. That's it. That's what we need. Three is always good. You know? Three's good. We'll de-leaf these guys here too on our way back. Another persimmons. There's another sapling. Awesome, awesome, awesome. There's the portal. Let's do a torch here and a torch here. Yeah, we don't need to go back to the other side at all now. Although we do have a blaze spawner in a pretty nice location at the other spot. Cool. All right, a little more rooming around in here, and maybe they the Optifine or something. They did something, change something on the game to make it, I think, a little bit easier to see, and it looks like it worked over here very, very well. So I tell you what, we're going to head back, put a hellbark tree in the ground and see if we can get it to grow and see what kind of wood it offers. And then we'll come back when we get back into the real world and I get some things taken care of. So I'll be right back. All right, let's see if we can get one of these hellbark trees to go. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Does it have to be planted on netherrack, perhaps? It might. I wonder if it has to be planted on netherrack, huh? Let's see, do these guys even grow? These guys you can plant anywhere. We can put these guys in the cemetery itself. But I wonder if the hellbark tree has to grow on the netherrack, since that seems to be what they're growing on in the nether. I guess they could grow on the flesh blocks too, which we could do. So, ouch, I've been withered. Let's put these guys someplace a little visible to us here when we come through. Yeah, like that. And then we had the eye bulb. Okay, these don't plant on the earth as well. So I bet you there's netherrack that those need to go on. And then we had a headstone. So let's put this headstone... Yeah, let's put the headstone right over here as we come up the hill. Yeah, there we go. That's good. Okay, so the rest of the stuff we'll figure out, and then I'll show it to you guys, okay? But right now, the second part of today's episode we need to get started on. I took you down and I showed you where we're going to be building the brewing room. So we need to go down in there. I was clearing that area out and wound up running into some zombies and stuff down in there. So we need to go down there and light that up, and there is a second cave nearby here that I would like to get lit up as well. So again, I'm going to take a quick little break, and then I'll be right back. All right, we're going in. Last time I was here, there was a zombie trying to get a hold of me, and I threw a block down, and he seemed to enjoy that more than getting at me. So let's go ahead and find our way down. You know, we've not done any caving since the beginning of this. At the very beginning, like episode 2. What's this? Limestone. This is limestone? Oh, nice. It's white too. There's all kinds of different white blocks. We're going to be using white blocks in our build for sure. Okay, here's some zombies. There's the guy holding my rock. Let me put a torch up for you guys. We're going to have to get some more coal. Because we're going to be out of torches before you know it. Maybe this won't go too far. So far, so good. Yeah, you know, I'm okay with that, too. I'm okay with this not going too far. Let's see up here. Anything up here? Worth note? Oh, limestone. That is really kind of nice, isn't it? Grab a few of those to take back. I want to get all the white blocks together and kind of set them up side by side and see what's whiter. Because we also have chalk. And the chalk is really nice as well. I like the chalk. What's this right here? This is raw marble. Okay, here's the raw marble, guys. There's more down here. Awesome. Fantastic. I love that. Yes, I do. Raw marble. It's been a while since I've been caving, except for with variety. When we do the 1.9 stuff, we've been doing the race to the nether, race to enchant. I think we're going to do one of those and just kind of post it and see how that goes. See what you guys think of it. It's pretty fun. This is limestone again. What happened to the raw marble? Was it just the one piece? Marble raw. Oh, that's tough to break. Raw marble. Oh, no, it wasn't. It was because I was using my fortune pick on it. Okay, and iron. I want to take a decent supply of iron with us over to the new place as well, so that we've got access to it. I did enchant us a brand new efficiency 4 unbreaking 3 pick. So we have a brand new one of those, which is really great. Come on. I want you. I want you, baby. I want you. There we go. Perfect. Oh, gosh. What is this? Did I... just fell into a little hole. See any coal over here? I don't see any coal. What's this here? We've got raw marble here as well. Oh, awesome. Very good. Very, very, very good. We're going to want a bunch of this stuff. I guess it is a little bit different. That's the limestone. It's a little bit different in color, isn't it? You can see the difference in the color for sure. This is very white. And then we've got limestone. Okay, so we're going to take this back with us, limestone. There's some coal right here. This is where we want to use our fortune pick, so we get a little extra coal. Our coal is really low right now, and we don't want it to get as low as I've let it get right now. What I should do is set up a bunch of oak trees or birch trees and start chopping those down and turning stacks of that into charcoal, which efficiently is much better because it takes one piece of coal to make then 8 charcoal. So that's probably something we need to start doing, is to get a decent birch tree farm or something like that going, where we can have access to that stuff. There we go. There's just one piece left. Bingo. All right. Beautiful. Oh, there's a little bit more coal right over here, too. Let's grab this. Our salt is in really good shape, but we'll take what we can, and then anything we don't need here at this place, we'll take with us. What we're going to do is we're going to take our backpacks, and we're going to fill them up with some goodies and take them over with us. So we've got some good starter materials, and then we'll... Ooh, what's that there? That's iron. No. You need to come to me, iron. There we go. Do I get more salt? Doesn't look like it. Just one salt, huh? There we go. Perfect. And over this way. Let's go ahead and turn this off for now. Like so. Oh, limestone. Okay, we're good there. Let's make a few more torches while we're at it. Excellent. Perfect. What's this here? More limestone. Yeah, that's got a very white look to it, doesn't it? Oh, this goes in a little ways now, doesn't it? Here we go. Now we're talking. I think I hear a skeleton. Oh, there he is. We could use those bones. I sure would like to find a skelly spawner, too. That would be really awesome if we could find a skeleton spawner. We're going to turn that water off. Normally, I don't do that, but I think for this case, we're going to turn it off. Okay, looks like he's all back here by himself. More limestone. Sounds like we got a zombie nearby, too. A little bit of iron. Nice. Perfect. excuse me. My afternoon voice issues. Someday maybe I won't have to do this in the afternoon anymore. It'd be nice. I talked about Rascal in our Q&A, and somebody said, but you mentioned you've got cats. What about a cat story? I said, okay, I could do a cat story. Let's tell you about the cats. I've got two cats. There's Giovanni and Wasabi. As a matter of fact, Wasabi is currently getting herself situated to sleep on a corner cabinet up here by me, like she does every day. They kind of both come in here and sit down and talk and just talk. They sit down here and they just listen to me talk is what they do. Checking for iron. Both of them are strays. Both of them are about 4 to 5 years old. We got them pretty close to each other. Wasabi actually came locally. Her mom was a feral cat. If you don't know what a feral cat is, it's a wild cat that doesn't have any, basically doesn't have people skills. And there's a group here. Ooh, okay, we need to get our bucket on the bar here. I hear a skeleton too. Last thing we need to be do is get knocked in by a skeleton here. Come on. Let's get that lava out of here. Yeah, there we go. So basically what happened was, this group go out and they trap these cats, these feral cats. They take the babies and the mother. They take the mother and they get her fixed and make it so she can't have babies anymore. And then they take and raise the babies and they adopt the babies out. So that's where Wasabi came from. She's a sweetheart. She's a tortie. She's just a little tiny thing. And she's a real sweetheart. I don't think that's going to be putting that fire out. We need to get this fire knocked out at its source. Let's get the bones out of here. Get some gravel on the bar. Hey, if you guys didn't know it, gravel douses lava, okay? It's really handy to have, especially when you're caving or when you're branch mining, so you have a little something extra on hand just in case. Let's see how this cheesecake does. Oh, not too bad. Not too bad at all. That'll work. That'll work for us. We're going to drop down here, boom, like so. Like that, and like that. Ooh, baby. What is that, another zombie over here? Holding the shovel? Hey, he's got an enchanted shovel. Oh, it's this villager zombie. Nice. You going to drop that enchanted shovel for me? He did. Efficiency 3. Nice. A chicken jockey. Look at this little guy. We'll let him come over here so you guys can see him. It's taking him forever to get here, though. He's like, why did I get the faulty chicken? Why did I get the bad chicken? This chicken doesn't know which way to run. He's all crooked and stuff. Oh, look at this schist down here. Oh, man, just a ton of schist. Oh, my. Oh, and I love it when I find flowers like this growing. I do. Some people don't really care too much about that, but I think it's really cool. Well, there we go. We just throw that away, right? It's perfect. It's exactly what you want to do. You just want to throw it away. We'll just douse this lava for now. Oh, baby. Okay, we've got all kinds of materials down here to gather up. Let's go ahead and do this. So, that's Wasabi. So, we got her, we had a cat at the time named Sushi, and he's no longer with us. He wound up disappearing, and we fear the worst for him because we do live in an area where there's coyotes and stuff, and Sushi was an outdoor cat for sure. He was very outdoorsy. Big, big boy. Sushi was just a huge cat. Just solid gray, too. He was just a beautiful cat. But he did not like Sushi or Wasabi at all. He actually really disliked her very much. So it probably turned out for the best anyways, unfortunately for him. But then Wasabi and we had Rascal, my dog. And then Rascal passed away. He died. And we thought, okay, we need to get another cat for Wasabi so she's got a friend. Because cats tend to like that better than I think the dogs do. At least my dog. Rascal didn't need friends. He had us, and he was pretty happy with us, you know? So let's get rid of this piece of green schist, too, so we don't have to carry that around with us. And a little bit more of that. There, ooh, a little bit of salt. Nice. Boom, like so. So where was I? So we had... Then Rascal died, so Wasabi was by herself, and so we decided, you know what, it's time to get another cat. So it just so happened that the place I work at, they were having the building painted, and the painters had found a kitten. under the building while they were painting it, and gave it to the gal who answers the phone where I work, and she took him home and gave him a home. And but her cat didn't like him because he was a kitten and her cat was pretty old, so she didn't want to keep him. And so we brought Giovanni home. And Giovanni is a tuxedo cat. And I always say he's the sexiest cat in America because he's black and white. And he's got cufflinks and everything. He's just like perfectly marked to where he's wearing a tuxedo. If you don't know what a tuxedo cat is, they're black and white. So that is Giovanni. And he is truly amazing. He's actually, sometimes I feel like he's Rascal reincarnated because Giovanni will actually play fetch with me. He loves it when you take and get... he likes the, you know how animals all have their own personality. Giovanni likes the receipts from the grocery store. You know those big long receipts you get? He loves that. If you take that and bring it home and you crumple it up and just crumpling it anywhere he is in the house, he will come running because he wants to play fetch with that piece of paper. And he is really good at fetch. He will actually tear after it through the kitchen, pick up that piece of paper, and then come right back and bring it back to me. And he wants me to throw it again. And I oblige him with that because I think the game is just so dang fun. Not to mention I've got this cat that likes to play fetch. Pretty crazy. You just don't find many cats that like to play fetch. But that's Giovanni. He is truly amazing. He's an amazing little man, for sure. Oh, wow, look at all this coal, too. You guys, we are just raking it in. I better check my back, because we've got an opening up there that's dark, and we do not need anybody coming out of there to cause us harm. Oh, this is perfect. So, yeah, we're going to turn this stuff into blocks, and then we'll take a bunch of blocks of coal with us and stuff. But like I said, when we get over to the new location, around episode 50, we may be able to head over there earlier than that. I want to be able to get started on the mine right away. There's a few things we need to do right off the bat that are going to be very important to us, and we'll have to take care of those things right off the bat, mine being one of them. Oh, wow, there's a lot of salt down there, isn't there? There we go. We'll just bring that stuff right on up to us. Oh, man, we don't have to stay down here for very long at all. We've got all kinds of goodies coming our way right away, too. And this will be all nice and shut down, too, so that's good. Oh, what's the purple stone? I've never seen the purple stone before. Hey, buddy. Give me your XP. Thank you. Oh, awesome. Very good. So, yeah, I've already got the new pick made, which is excellent. Oh, I think I was using the wrong pick on that coal over there last time we were out there when we were digging coal up. Was digging up much faster than this. Sometimes I forget to switch because I don't do a whole lot of this, you know. That's the nice thing about Minecraft is you can grind for about an hour or two and you've got so many supplies, and especially with modded Minecraft, that you can build for quite a while without having to worry about it. And we've been building a lot with wood. I hear a zombie. There we go. More coal. A lot more coal. Excellent. Anything else I could tell you about Giovanni and Wasabi? I don't think so. Oh, hello. Boop, you're dead. What'd you drop there? What you got there? Let's get rid of the fossil. Leather, projectile protection 4, unbreaking 3. Wow, that's actually pretty good for leather armor, isn't it? Let's break open the backpack. We're here for coal and iron, and so far we're doing pretty good on both. We got some good stuff. And well, I didn't realize we got gold, too. I'm going to put that right there. Peridot right there. There's some more coal, and we'll take the iron, and we'll put that there, and the gold there. Excellent. Yeah, let's get some of this stuff out of our inventory. There you can see the kind of the difference, huh, in the two. Not bad. They look really good. I like them. Backpack. Oop. Boy, oh boy. That's going to cost me. One of these days, it's going to cost me to do that. Oh, hello, creeper. Are you stuck there? What is this purple rock? We've got to check out this purple rock. It's pretty cool. Another creeper. Kaboom. My finger slipped off of the S button. It surely did. Ooh, what's this? Andesite. Oh, this does some twisting and turning, huh? I see outside. I see the light. I see outside light there. Oh, good. More bones. Take those bones. Sure wish it was a spawner. Oh! Oh! There you go, Radio. Get the sword on your bar, you fool. Chalk. There's more chalk. The other white stone. Yeah, I'm not a very good fighter. Definitely need practice in the fighting area. Oh, man. Oh, that's nice. That is really good stuff right there. All right, let's go see if we can find that purple stone, if I haven't wandered too far away from it. Andesite chalk. Okay, good deal. Okay, so which way did we come from here? Did we come up this way? We did come up this way. There's coal here. I can always come back for the coal. We're doing pretty good. I do want to get more, though. Definitely want to get more coal. Oh, this is what we don't want to pass up on. Oh, lots of zombies there, huh? Tanzanite ore. Ooh. We've never got tanzanite ore other than finding it on that old shipwreck that was sitting above ground in the bog. That's where we found that. But yeah, I'll take the tanzanite. That's pretty cool. What can you do with tanzanite? And should I be breaking it with my fortune pick? Fortune 3 pick. Water. Oh man, this place just twists and turns down here, doesn't it? Just twisting and turning. This is... Was that iron or gold? I think that was gold. It seems kind of weird that we've got gold showing up at this level, doesn't it? Doing pretty good though with our diamond armor and all. I'd say so. We'll go until we run out of food. Sticks, coal, bam. Alright, nice. Awesome. Resources. Galore. Lapis, I'm assuming. Let's see, do we get more? What if I use the Fortune 3 pick? Just one there. We'll have to test that again and see if maybe it gives us a little bit more. Okay, I don't see any metals here. Salt. Oh, by the way, I put a salt lick out by the cattle. So they do have a salt lick out there now. That's just salt in your inventory in the crafting bench all the way around. And you get a nice salt block. Oh, that's more gold. Oh man, this is great. We're going to need a lot of gold for the GEI because we're going to have rails to put in. Power rails, so that's awesome. We'll have to do a lot more of the caving, that's for sure. These builds right now that we've been doing so far have been pretty simple and basic, but it's going to get a lot more elaborate once we move to the GEI, that's for sure. It's going to take more resources, it's going to take longer to accomplish each of the pieces, and that's just how my space station builds go. It's going to be a little bit different. We're going to have to take this back. All the XP we get off of this stuff we're going to have to use to fix this Fortune 3 pick. Alright, so we had a downward spiral thing here. This goes down. Okay, we're going to take this down and see where it goes. There goes Giovanni. He's on his way up to the cabinet right now. Hello! He's just like, ouch. Yeah, that's right, it hurts. Call your mama. Tell your mama. Ooh, we're getting some serious iron. That is nice. Never have I used so much iron before than I have right now. So you guys have a good weekend? I think I told you what I did on my weekend. Yeah, I did. I did. We're just wrapping things up here on the farm. And then it's what's going to be nice is we're going to be able to go in the Nether. We'll set our portal up. I think the islands that sit beneath that boulder out at the GEI site, the tallest of those islands, we will put a our Nether portal on that. And then we'll be able to go back and forth and see both areas. I think that's going to be our best bet. Okay, let's do something like that. Goodbye, lava. Goodbye, lava. Goodbye, lava. This is all right underneath our house, too. You're dead, creeper. Give me your poo. Oh, wow, this place is amazing. Just keeps on going. This is a big cave system. I had no idea it was going to be this big. Usually when I say I'm going to go caving, I hit enter the cave and there's nothing there. It's just this little dead-end spot, but that does not seem to be the case here this time. This is really, really going on and on and on. We're going to leave that the way it is and go back this way. Might as well break that out too. A little extra light back there. It's not too bad. It's not too dark. Sometimes it can be so dark back in these places, you know, that I'm worried about doing a video like this because it is so dark. Oh yeah, don't think I missed you. I see you. I see you. I see you, Cole. Oh man, there's so much coal here. Let's try going down a little bit deeper. Okay, we're kind of back. This is where we killed the little zombie guy on the chicken jockey. Come on, in you go. And there we go. That's a much easier way to get the stuff as opposed to dropping down into it. Is this where we came in at? We doused some lava with our bucket of water. There he is. There's our little boy. There's our little guy. I love how they shake their head no. No. Yes, I'm afraid you have to die. Ooh, we're lava level now. Where is he? Okay, that took care of that. Well, I'm a little nervous about... Oh, there he is. Good, good. I don't like the fact that he's roaming around and we've got bunch of lava here. We're gonna have to get some obsidian too for our next portal. Oh, maybe we get lucky enough to find some diamonds today, huh? Are we already down diamond level? Is that even possible? Let's see. God, we are. We're on level 11. That is just nuts, huh? I had no idea. Oh, you eat my redstone. How dare you eat my redstone? Alright, we're good here. We need to check this area out up here first. I don't like walking around down below this. It's not safe. Enderman, I would love to kill you. Yeah! There we go. I'll take that pearl. Nice. All kinds of coal and stuff. Wow, I'm going to come back here and I'm just going to stock up on coal. It's just crazy. It is nuts how much coal is up here. Torches. Let's see. Do we have any more sticks? We do not. Oop, let's get one more of those. Do that. And we'll take half of those up there. Put those right there. We're going to have to break out the backpack and get some stuff put away again. Nice. That's great to hear. That is great. All right, so let's see. Iron. What are we doing? Over a stack of iron now. You know what? Maybe I should keep going for a little bit and then come back if anything exciting happens. And we'll go from there. But right now, as you can see, we are doing pretty darn good here. Where did we get a slime ball at? Huh, that's interesting. Don't know where that came from. But we got one. We got a... Oh my god, why do I keep throwing my backpack today? That is nuts. I'm going to pay for that dearly. Alright, yeah, I'm going to get to a few more things. If I run into some diamonds, I'll bring you guys back. But until then, yeah, let me just keep digging around. I'm just going to keep creeping around in here and grabbing the iron and stuff and see if we can find some diamonds. Maybe I should keep you with me until we get past this big lava field here and see if there's any diamonds down in here. Let's see. We'll see where this goes. I love these kind of caves that do this. Open up into a whole different room and system of cave. Pretty cool. Alright, we're good. We're golden. Come on, let me get through here. No diamonds, though. Alright, I'll be back. Alright, we're done. We're out. Where does this bring us? Oh my gosh, look at this. Look how close we are to home. There's the barn. Yeah, we're just back behind the pasture here. Yeah, just behind the pasture. Cool. Very, very cool. A lot of cave down there, though. Holy cow, I just found a bunch more of it that is just, you know, just sitting there waiting to be harvested and stuff. So there's still a ton of stuff down there that we can grab hold of. But we didn't do too bad. Let's take a look at what we got for our goods. Let's head for home. I don't know if the sun coming up, going down. Looks like the sun is just, it's starting to go down. Perfect. Yeah, here we go. Here's a piece of this cave. I almost found this exit, I think. No, I did not. We get zombies coming out of here on a regular basis, though, so that's good to have that. Some of that area shut down. This is going to push more of the mobs to the surface, though, now, because they've got less area to spawn underneath us. But that's okay. That's all right. We needed the resources. Let's go inside and take a look. We're going to go in the shed here, and we'll see exactly just what we have. And then I'm going to figure out how to get those hellbark trees going, and we'll do that next episode. We'll get a hellbark tree going. All right, let's get the backpack open. We need the backpack. There we go. This is our caving backpack, the gray one. So let's see. What do we got here for iron? Look at that. 30 gold, almost 2 stacks of iron. Salt. Wow, 1.5 stacks of salt. The peridot. By the way, the tanzanite, you can get more of it if you use the Fortune 3 pick. We did get extra when I did that. Redstone. Wow, we didn't do too bad at redstone. The coal is what we were after, as well as the iron, and I think we did really well on both those fronts. Look at that. That is just, that is really nice. That's quite a few stacks. 2, 4, 6, 8, 8.5 stacks of coal, a little bit of gunpowder. We have an enchanted shovel, as well as the leather tunic, and some interesting blocks. We even picked up a bow, which we don't need. We'll just throw that thing aside, but, yeah, so not too bad, huh? Look at that. That's some nice XP. Speaking of XP as well, we are back up to 30 XP. So that means I can do some enchanting and get us maybe another. What should I do? What should I be enchanting anyways? I'm kind of curious about that. I'm not sure. I don't know that we need another kind of sword because we have such great swords as it is right now. You know, we really have great swords. These pink ones are awesome. I mean, Unbreaking 3, Sharpness 5, they're going to last us a long time, and I don't know that we need anything else other than maybe some flame or something on there, so I like those swords. If you got an idea as to what we should enchant next, let me know, and I'll hold on to the 30 XP. Otherwise, what I think we should do is maybe take this, repair it, and put Unbreaking 3 on it, or create an entirely new Fortune 3 pick is what we probably should do. I could even take these two and combine them on the anvil, probably relatively inexpensively. I'll look into that and combine these two so that our Fortune 3, because this one's getting too expensive to fix on its own. But if we throw this on there, that might reduce the cost and allow us to take it a little bit longer. But that is going to do it for me. Kind of a different episode. We hadn't gone caving before, but look at us. Sporting our diamond armor, our diamond tools. Carrot cake to munch on, huh? Yeah, carrot cake. What do you know about that carrot cake? It's pretty good, too. It doesn't do too bad. It gives us a couple bars of saturation stuff. It worked out pretty good, I think. Pretty darn good. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Again, thank you so much for your support. I really do appreciate your time watching the videos. Hitting that like button for me if you enjoy the episode. Comment, subscribe, and share. I'm the Radio Man 03. I want you to have an awesome, fantastic, and superb day. It's almost moving day for us, and I'll talk to you again next time.